These technologies will enable companies to move from the current product or transaction-centered approach to a true customer-centric approach. We have been talking about that, we have been hearing about that in university for decades, but now with the now available data, with the now available analysis technologies, we are finally in the position to really make it happen. What does customer-centric approach mean? It means maybe not yet to go to hyper-personalization, but to definitely come up with a more targeted, more precise segmentation than today. It means an individualized offering. It means a clearly super-targeted promotions rather than throwing money out of the window. And of course, it means dynamic pricing. And last but not least, it means massive increase of sales force effectiveness through using digital channels, but also the available large data. Machine learning makes most sense in industries with many customers, with a big number of transactions, and with a large amount of available data. Just to name a few, retail, financial services, all kind of subscription businesses like telecommunications and energy, but also B2B, if you think of spot markets in B2B, or if you think of machinery, with all the available data coming from the sensors which currently provide data in the machines. You should not have too much faith in the machine or software results. Check why certain actions, for instance, a price increase or decrease, are recommended, and then analyze whether that, in your experience, makes sense or not. We call that face validity check. If it is a purely black box model, with no information on the accuracy of that model, be very cautious. And then finally, please don't underestimate the time you need to prepare and set up the data for these kind of projects. 80 to 90% of the project time is used for data engineering and only 10 to 20% for the true modeling of that. Finally, always, always combine data scientists and true industry experts. Machine learning makes our pricing much more accurate and precise, and therefore also more profitable. And that is true for B2C, but it's also true for B2B. For instance, in our B2B peer pricing models, we have in the meanwhile integrated machine learning algorithms, which on a permanent basis optimize the recommended price which is given to salespeople. So every single transaction has an influence on the newly recommended price. Machine learning also makes the pricing much more differentiated than before. One size fits all is history. Finally, it enables us to change prices much faster than before. The key word is here, dynamic pricing. That works perfectly in online or in the e-tailing business, but not everywhere. Be cautious. Let's take as an example Apple. Apple has all the data you can think of to come up with the perfect dynamic pricing. Still, what they are doing and what they are using is one of the most boring pricing systems you can think of. Different sizes, different colors, and that's it. Why? Because they are convinced that dynamic pricing would maybe not destroy, but would have a negative impact on the overall brand value. So dynamic pricing is a great approach which will lead to significant profit increases, but not everywhere.